Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to see about what is ALL and ALLExcept functions in DAX. We are exploring powerbi using a business scenario Naga garments, and for this business, how these two functions will be helpful. Let us see it in a demo. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in powerbi. We have a simple model here, having sales and two tables that those who are following my channel, they are familiar with. And now let us try to understand ALL. So ALL function is nothing but it will return a table, and mean it will remove all the filters from the table. So it can be used in many purpose. One of the purpose of ALL function is to create a new table. Let's say I want a duplicate table of product master. So what I can do is, let's say ALL of, I can put product master, okay, then product reference, something like that. Okay, maybe I need a distinct columns of all the values, something like that. I can go for it. So for now, I'll say ALL of product master. I kept it as product reference. So I get immediately a new table with all the column names. Okay, you can go and see here product reference. So it is same, and you see product my original table, it is same. Even in the relationship tab, you will have a new table here. Okay, there might be some scenarios you need a reference table. Okay, you need a copy of some table. In that case, you can go for ALL function. That is point number one. So next, I want to highlight another important use of ALL DAX function is like, now I'm seeing the total sales by category wise total sales, how much this each category is contributing to the total sales, that I want to understand. So for that, what I can do is I can create a new measure. Okay, so what I need to do is ALL sales. Let me take calculate total sales. That is my default measure. Total sales is very simple. Let me zoom in a little bit of this calculation, comma, ALL of sales table. Okay, first I am putting the entire table now. Calculate, comma, ALL. What happened? I closed it, so I thought end of the function. So I will put sales. Let us put sales now, then let us check what are other options. Okay, now this is ALL sales. Now when I put this measure in my table, you look at here, this ALL sales returns the total of your sales. So when I put this ALL sales as a label here, visualization data labels, instead of data label I'll put none, then I'll say the category, the size I will increase so that you can see what is this. Okay, so this is your ALL sales. So ALL sales is nothing but the ALL function is remove all the filters applied in your table. So when you say ALL of sales, so it consider entire table. You filter by status, you filter by order type, it ignore all the filters. So the overall sum of a particular column or whatever you aggregated, okay, that will be shown. So now when I apply Chennai, you see there is no change. When I apply accessories, there is no change. It indicates like the entire total sales, this whole figure will be displayed. That is what this ALL function will do. So ALL means all the records in your table, ignore any filter applies on that table. That is your ALL. So on what scenarios you will use? So now you want to have this percentage, how much it has contributed. You usually do this one. Okay, so this is one thing. So let us try to create a new measure to create a percentage, how much it has contributed. Percentage of category sales. Okay, so here I'll say like calculate, or I can just go by divide my total sales comma all sales. Okay, so my percentage category sales, instead of this I need to put it here, then make it as percentage. Okay, now you see here my 63% of sales is from casual wear and my accessories is very less. Okay, so in this way he can able to understand where his sales is happening. So if you see in percentage, it will be very easy to identify. So that is where your all function plays a vital role here. Let's see our next function, that is all except. Okay, now let us try to create all except function. In what scenarios we'll use, we'll check it later, I mean after creating a measure. So new measure, sales category all except. Okay, usually it will not be like this. You have a proper naming convention, I mean based on your measure values you can put that one, all except. So what is the syntax is like, you need to specify all except a table name. So I want sales table comma I want a product category. Okay, I'm not using the column reference from the dimension, I'm having everything in a single table. Okay, okay, now we have this all except measure created. So what it will do is it will ignore all the filters applied on the sales table and accept this product category. Okay, what I meant, let us see it quickly in a data. Now let me put this one here. Okay, now this shows both our same data, since it will keep the filters of this product category and ignore all other filters. Okay, let us try to express this one by clicking on allocation. So what all except is doing, you see here it ignores this location filter, right? That is what this all except is doing. It removes all the filters in the sales and accept this product category. Okay, that is the main difference between all and all except. So let us try to understand it better by putting a product name also. So when we put product name, even here this ignores this all except, ignores this filter. You understand this filter context now, like this works as the total sales is the base measure that works with the proper filter context, that is the formula is sum of sales. So this total sales splits by each filter context and displaying the total sales for this Bangalore. But what happened to all except? When I uncheck it, the total of this accessories, right, where we can see it here, like this is my total of accessories. So this total is appearing for both the accessories here, right? Even when I click on Chennai, that doesn't matter. Even for Chennai and this chain wallet, it doesn't filter. Okay, so ignore all the filters from the other columns in the table, keep only the filters for this category. That is what the all except is doing all about. So in what scenarios you will use? Obviously it's like how much contribution this has made against each product. Say for example here, if the user chooses here for this particular location, in this location his total sales of accessories is 195, whereas across all accessories different locations this is his total. So he wants to analyze this percentage, then he can use the divide and use that one. So like this, people want to analyze the percentage irrespective of the filters they apply. I hope you guys understand when to use all and all except. If you like this video, share and subscribe to the channel. Comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.